this two-part program where we recognize our young people. We did last night at the party for one that could not be here tonight. But to do this is the guy that heads us up. And that's our Keepers of the Dance chairman and our executive director, Bob Miley. Thank you, Sam. If this were a movie, I'd say that since I'm speaking, it's time to go out and get popcorn and Coca-Cola's if y'all want to. Except for the subject matter, and that's the kids. And every year, it's my honor to present the awards to the Keepers of the Dance, and you guys have heard me do this many, many years. As a matter of fact, it's been over 15 years that we give the Keepers of the Dance Award. The Hall of Fame is celebrating our 30th anniversary. Keepers have been with us at least half of that time, and that was, as you guys well know, it was a brainchild of Harry Driver and Chick Hatton. And they wanted to honor the young people, hopefully the future Shag Club presidents, Hall of Famers, SOS icons, whatever, because these guys were instrumental, these guys and gals were going to be instrumental in keeping this dance alive. And so far, we've done it real well. And you know where Keeper's Corner is, it's over at Harold, in the back room in the corner, and we've got all of the kids and their biographies recognized, and they're hanging on the wall. And tonight, we're going to add two more. First, let me say this. Last night, we honored Norman Aldridge. He is a keeper this year, and he couldn't be here tonight. He's the executive chef at Marriott Hotel, one of Marriott's in Atlanta. And they had a big deal going on this weekend, but he made the effort to come up Thursday night and last night we honored him at a party at the cafe. He danced and got his little prize and his plaque. He was so happy. I'm glad that most of you guys got to see him. So we won't have the privilege of watching Norman dance again tonight, but he'll be around. He promised me he's coming to the Keepers Contest in February, which I'll talk about a little bit in just a minute. Anyway, the Keepers, I'd be remiss if I didn't recognize some people that are instrumental in the Junior Shack. I think the Keepers are doing their part, but I'd like to recognize Ellen Taylor. Her efforts to the Junior Shag Association. Miss Ellen. And for years and years with the Keepers, if I ever needed any money or any help, I'd call on Catherine and Eddie Mansour. They have Catherine and Eddie. They have helped the youth of this dance so much. And their work with the Junior Shag and the juniors, sponsoring contests, and goodwill work, and sponsoring projects that the juniors have done, and their work with the foundation, Hall of Fame Foundation, is astronomical. And without people like this, there would be no Shag Dance. There would be no juniors coming along, keeping it going and promoting it. So think about these people. If you have some extra bucks to help some people that need help, or if you want to have some juniors come along, Ellen has a shoe program with it. Juniors, people donate their dance shoes to the Junior Shaggers. That's been a wonderful thing. So thank you guys so much for that. One last thing before I get into talking about our newest female keeper. The Keepers of the Dance themselves, we have right at 30. I lost the exact number, but it's give or take 30 keepers right now. And they always, over the last few years, have kind of floated in the SOS parade, got together, and come together as a group. They support the Keepers of the Dance contest at Harold's in February, which I've had Barry Thigpen tell me, you know, Barry, he's pretty good at giving dance contests. But I've had Barry walk up to me and say, how do you do that? And the way I do it is I have the greatest kids in the world that come and dance and promote this thing, the greatest dancers. And in the last several years, as a result of that contest, we have given donations to the Hall of Fame Foundation, to the Beth Mitchell Scholarship, and to the Judy Kennedy Scholarship. And the keepers will keep working, and I'll keep doing what little bit I do, and the board and the committee, and we'll keep having these contests and donating to these worthy old charities and colleges. And so let's give the keepers a hand. Okay, now we're gonna miss Norman, and I hate that, but he did his thing last night, so we're gonna go to the female keeper of the dance this year. She was born in Sanford, North Carolina, back in 1985. She watched her mother and father dance in contests, learned how to dance, and she saw them do a belly roll, and she said, "Ooh, that's gross, I'll never do that." But soon she went to Junior SOS in 1998, and like so many of those kids, she got hooked, started taking lessons, and she learned from some of the best. Sandra and Wes May, Susie Beaver, Sam West, Scott Campbell, Percy Thornton, and many others. And she started dancing, and she became a wonderful dancer and a wonderful ambassador for the dance. She was a 2008, I'm sorry, pro champion, non-pro champion in the Nationals, very thin pitch contest. And she was a member of the 2009 National Shag Dance Championships dance team. But she tells me her greatest honor was in 2005 when she received the Beth Mitchell Scholarship. And trust me, that's a hard one to get, and it's well-deserved, the recipients. And then, she was on a roll. The following year, she received the Judy Kennedy Scholarship. We don't have any double scholarship recipients, and so that shows that it's not just all about dancing, folks. It's about what you give back, what you do in your life, what you do for the community. And this young lady has certainly done it. She graduated with a master's in elementary education, master's in special education. She teaches fourth and fifth grade students with disabilities. She's still dancing, she's still loving it, she says it's had a profound effect on her life. I'd like to introduce to you tonight Christina Woodruff. Christina. Christina.
From the first time I saw her Dance Night 4th of July contest in Sanford at River Birch. I never imagined, Crystal, that I would get not just the best friend, but a sister also, so thank you for always being there for me. And I want to thank my mom and my dad for being here tonight. So they have been the two best parents I ever could have asked for. Lastly, I want to thank Casey, who I never imagined I'd meet the love of my life through dance. And I thank him for loving me and being there for me always. So thank you for that. So again, thank you so much for this honor. I appreciate it. And thank you.
Thank you, Christine. We're going to let her dance in just a minute, but before we do, are there any keepers in the house? Any keepers of the dance? I'd like you guys to come up, please. I know we got a couple here. We got a bunch of them on a cruise. Not a cruise, but they're on a visit to Florida, to the island. Okay, but we got a few here. Christina, walk down and get your picture taken with these guys. Monty, do one over here in front. Okay, thanks, kids. If you guys will stay up here, we're going to let Christina dance. You guys have a seat right there. Christina, Mr. DJ. Norman and Christina and all the keepers, folks. Thank you very much. Sam?
That was absolutely beautiful. And to see you dance slow was even more beautiful, because we don't see that often.